Hello everyone, welcome back. If you are new to my channel, please consider subscribing. This is the second part of number system conversion. So the first conversion in this video is octal to hexadecimal. So octal to hexadecimal number system. So octal number system, its radix is 8 and hexadecimal number, its radix is 16. So there is no direct conversion from octal to hexadecimal number system. So the procedure which we follow is, in step 1, we will convert this octal number system into its corresponding binary number system. Its corresponding binary number system by converting each octal bit into corresponding 3 binary bits. So that is the first step in conversion from octal to hexadecimal. In the second step, this converted binary is converted into its corresponding hexadecimal equivalent. It is converted into its corresponding hexadecimal equivalent. So binary to hexadecimal each, so 4 bits or 4 binary bits are grouped, which is called as nibble, and corresponding value of the nibble is written in hexadecimal form in order to obtain the final output, which is in hexadecimal form, that is from octal to hexadecimal conversion. So these are the 2 steps which we follow for conversion of octal to hexadecimal number system. Now we'll see an example. 615.25 base 8 is what in hexadecimal number system. So in step 1, we'll convert this octal number system into its corresponding binary by grouping into 3, by making this octal, each bit in octal, into its corresponding 3 binary digits by using these values. So by using these values we are going to convert. So 6 in binary is represented by 1101, is represented by 001, and 5 is represented by 101. Dot is there, so we have to keep the same place dot, and 2 is represented by 010 and 5 by 101. So it is now converted into binary. The octal number system, octal number is now converted into binary. That is, first step is completed. Now in the second step, each binary, so this binary number is converted into hexadecimal number system by grouping into 4 bits, and that grouping is from right to left. So it is from right to left in the case of integer part, as we have discussed in the previous video, and from left to right for fractional part. And I have given you an example also on this. Okay, so that grouping is like this. So 4 bits forms one group, and these 4 bits forms the other group, and these 4 bits, now appending zeros, this forms another group. Now for fractional part, from left to right, so this forms one group and this again forms the other group. So the equivalent number for this 0001 is 1, and 1000 is 8. 1101, its corresponding is 13, and 13 corresponding is D. So as we know, 10 corresponding number is A, and 11 for B, 12 for C, 13 for D, 14 for E, and 15 is represented with F. So 1101 is 13, it is represented by D dot. 0101 is 5, and 0100 is 4. So this is its corresponding hexadecimal equivalent, or we can write it as 18D dot 54 base 16. Okay, so this is how we can convert an octal number system into its corresponding hexadecimal number system. So there are two steps. First is conversion of octal to binary like this, and then binary digits are converted by grouping into its corresponding hexadecimal, which is the second step in this conversion. Okay, so the next conversion is hexadecimal to octal conversion. Okay, hexadecimal to octal conversion, that is reverse conversion of the previous one, right? So we don't have any conversion directly from hexadecimal to octal as well, right? First hexadecimal, so hexadecimal to octal conversion involves, first is hexadecimal to binary conversion has to be done, and then second you have to convert this binary to octal. Okay, so these two conversions has to be done. Okay, so direct conversion of hexadecimal to octal is not available, so we have to convert first hexadecimal into binary, right? How we can convert? By converting each bit. So how this conversion can be done? Converting each bit in hexadecimal, each bit in hexadecimal is converted into 4 bits in binary, is converted into 4 bits in binary. Okay, so thereby you will achieve this conversion, and once binary is converted, you can convert binary to octal by grouping 3 bits, right? So for integer part we move from right to left, and for fractional part we move from left to right. Okay, let us take an example, then we'll understand very clearly the concept. BC66.AF. So this is an hexadecimal system. I want to convert this into octal system. So what is it? Its value, its corresponding value in octal number system. Right. So first is binary, hexadecimal is converted into binary. So B. So from this table you can see B value is 1011. So each bit in hexadecimal is converted into 4 bits. So these are the equivalent bits. So equivalent representation of B is 1011. So B is represented by 1011. Similarly, C is represented by 1100. Right. 6 is represented by 0110. Again, 6 is there, so it is 0110. So dot is there, we have to keep the same dot here. So A means 10. So 10 is represented by 1010. And F is represented by 4 ones. Okay, so this is what you have got in binary. The first conversion is completed. And next we have to group 3 bits at a time. So this is integer part. So this part is integer part and this part is fractional part. Okay, so the part which is present after this decimal point is called fractional part, and the part which is present before decimal point is integer part. So integer part, we have to move from right to left. So right to left, we have to group 3 bits at a time. So these 3 bits forms first group. These 3 bits form the second group, these 3 bits forms the third group, and these 3 bits forms the fourth group, and similarly these 3 forms the fifth group, and you can add 2 zeros, this forms the last group. Right, next we have to move from left to right in the case of fractional part. So these 3 forms one group here, and you can add 0, so this forms one group. Now you can write the equivalent octal number. So this is the equivalent octal number, so up to 7. So 001 represents here, 001 is 1. 011, 011 represents 3. Okay, so 110 represents 6, and again 001, it represents 4. 001 represents 1, and 100 represents 4, and 110 represents 6 again. Dot is there, we have to keep the same dot. And 101 is 5. Next 011 is 3. Next 110 is 6. So this is the equivalent number in octal for this decimal equivalent number. Okay, so this is how we can convert a given hexadecimal number into its corresponding octal number. So direct conversion never exists. So we have to convert first hexadecimal number into binary by converting each bit into four bits in binary. So using this table, right? And we have to group 33 bits, right, for integer part from right to left, and for fractional part from left to right. And then we have to write its corresponding octal number by using this table, right? So this is the conversion. Okay.